up, Kate? What's up, Zach? How you guys doing?
We're doing good.
Good. How are you?
Good, good. I guess I'll start with you first, Kate. Midnight Mass. What can people expect to see? What is this series all about?
Midnight Mass is a slow burn about a fishing community who have kind of closed ranks, and a young priest comes and miracles start to happen.
Yeah, I know. What a great setup. Zach, when you first heard you're going to be a part of this, I mean, how blown away were you? I mean, it's not often you get something that's like that unique and original.
I was excited. You know, to be honest, when I auditioned, I only had two scenes. That's all I knew, besides the fact that I'd seen Haunting of Hill House and loved it and loved Kate. And that's all I knew about the project. But the scenes that I got to read were really cool. And then I was told I had the job, and then I got to read the scripts. I was like, holy shit, like, this is really good and like different, which is cool, because so much of what we do is just another version of something we've already seen. And this is, there's nothing like this.
Yeah. What made the experience of working on this project so special for you, Kate?
Well, our project was about to go when the world shut down and we all got sent home. And there was about a 4-month period where we didn't know if we were ever going to make this. And right before we left, we had gotten to do this table read with the whole cast, all 7 episodes, and we didn't record it. But there was a version of the world where we only got to do it once and with each other. And so when we came back, not only had like the sets really settled into the land and so there's been overgrowth, Zach's face was the only face that I saw, like full face for days at a time, because everybody else was in the goggles and the mask and the shield and the surgical gowns, because this was like the first COVID wave. Everyone didn't know how it was transmitted. And so we'd show up to set, we'd sit in our cars, we'd get our temperature checks, we would get in full surgical gear. And the only person I could talk to was Zach. And it was
so sorry.
It sounded awful when I just said it, but it created an intimacy. And he was, I mean, I was a fan before I was his friend. And now I look back at that time and the Midnight Mass family as true family members because of the intimacy it was created.
That's a great story. And for you, Zach, man, you play such an interesting and layered character. I mean, what was it like to bring him to life, and were there any challenges to it?
I mean, this was the hardest role I've had to do in a while. And it was really exciting to do, and I had to do my homework. You know, I think I said it to Kate at one point after one of the scenes we did, like, you know, because I think it was after the crying scene, that's like every scene. I was a little worried that you're just like watching Riley mope around and cry all day for 5 episodes.
But you're so luckily, cute when you mope.
It's a little more complex, but you do these scenes where you like crying or emotional. And I was like, man, the end of those scenes, you just feel shitty because you either feel like you did a bad job, so you feel shitty about yourself because you're a bad actor, or you feel bad because you went to some bad, dark, yucky place and you're just still there. So luckily, like, the people I got to work with were amazing. The character was in a, you know, pretty dark place, and that was hard sometimes. I also had this other layer of 2.5 months of being away from my family, which sucked. Yeah. And I didn't even realize how like depressed I was, which I think helped the character, but
it added to it, right?
No, it added to it. I didn't even realize. I think Sam told me this story, but Kate, maybe it was you, where when my family came up and they met my wife, Keely, they were like, yeah, Zach was like, mm-mm. And like at one point she said, at one point he was like, yeah, I just washed my clothes and then I just put them in a pile on the floor. Cause what's the point?
Zach was very depressed. This character, yeah. Riley got to Zach in a way. Yeah. Occasionally I'd catch him wandering around, like looking at plants, like standing there, just thinking his thoughts. And I didn't know Zach, I thought maybe that's who Zach was, but yeah. No.
I'm a very different person. I was trying to, our big joke, which it wasn't even a joke, was like, I was trying to like do my version of Meet Joe Black, Brad Pitt's character. Just kind of very still.
Yeah,
listening and just kind of like, what's the point?
Kind of, now that you reference that, I can kind of see that now after watching. I get that. And last question for you, Kate. The thing that I really loved about the series is, man, I know it's a fictional town and a fictional place, but it felt so real. Where did you guys primarily film?
We were all over Vancouver. But I think part of the reason it feels like that is because those sets were built in Langley and Stevenson, and then we disappeared for a number of months, but the houses stayed up. So there was overgrowth and there was weathering, but every single thing, roads, telephone poles, the lights, every single weather vane, every single house built on location for set. None of that was found.
Wow, yeah, it was one of the most amazing sets I've ever been on. I was very blown away by whoever created those.
Yeah. I hope they did. They destroy them after, or are they still around?
No, they're gone. We burned down most of them.
Ah, man. Oh, well, great series. Thanks for your time. No, it's all for, like you said, you were depressed for the art. They built the sets for the art. It's all for the art.
That's all for the art.